Good evening. Oh, there we are. And welcome to the First Presbyterian Church of Richmond. My name is Jason Brown, and I have the distinct pleasure of serving this congregation as Minister of Music and Arts. I want to start by thanking you all for being here to support the Music and Arts Ministry and for your support of the good and necessary work of RISC. You'll hear a bit more about them later in the program. But before we get things started, I'd like to ask you, please, I know that we have some important folks here, so I won't ask you to turn yours off, but if you would silence your cell phone or any other electronic device so that we don't disturb folks as the shenanigans ensue. It is my pleasure to share with all of you the wonderful talents of the Austin College a cappella choir. I had the pleasure of listening to them rehearse this evening, and I can promise you that you're in for a treat. So, we're already 5 minutes behind schedule, and I will get out of the way of you and a fine evening of music. Again, thank you for being here, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you for coming tonight very much. We are the Austin College a cappella choir. Austin College is in Texas. It's just north of Dallas. And so we started out pretty early this morning, but we're here now and we're ready to go. The first part of this concert, the first half of this concert, is really kind of a trip through the development of the college choir. This choir in some form has been at Austin College since about 1900. Back when it was a military academy. And there's been choirs at Austin College ever since. And so we're sort of taking a trip through the kind of music that a college choir would sing. Not so much a university choir, but a college choir. Now, I did promise my ensemble that I would not talk, so this is as much as I'm going to talk, probably. If you would like to follow along, there are texts in the program. There's also some brief discussion of the music, and we will get on.
Yeah.
It is my great pleasure to introduce to you my assistant director, who thinks she's going to graduate in May, but I'm really not sure I'm going to allow it to happen. And she will be conducting the first of her two pieces tonight. This is the Abendlied of Rheinberger.
Thank you.
Excuse us while we do a little bit of, moving, I guess it is. This group in front of you, I'm not exactly sure what the name of it is. I know what I think the name of it is. The name of it is the Quartet. Now, it's not that we can't do math at liberal arts colleges. It's that the very, very first ensemble at Austin College ever was called the Quartet. And it was actually a quartet because apparently their math was better than ours. But there was always three students. This is back when Austin College was a men's college. Three students and one faculty member. I happen to be the faculty member. And so we would like to, by the way, they have other names. They want me to call them the Brovertones. I'm tempted to see. If you laugh, it just encourages them. I'm tempted to take a poll, but not right now. So we'd like to sing three tunes for you. The first is a King Singer's arrangement of the tune MLK. Now we'd like to do an old doo-wop song. This is actually an arrangement by a newer group called Boys to Men, but it's an old doo-wop song from the late 50s, In the Still of the Night.
Shoo, 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 sh
And the last song we would like to do for you before we take a little bit of an intermission is an arrangement for a group called the Vocal Union. Vocal Union for a while was actually based in Dallas. This is their arrangement of Sweet Beulah Land.
Oh, sweet home.
And we will be back in 10 minutes.
Well, let the church say amen. There is an intermission listed in your program, and that's an intermission for them, not for you. Some portion of that 10 minutes will be taken up by Reverend Derek Starr Redwine and Emily Small to talk about risk and why we are here this evening and what we can do to help somebody experience a little piece of Beulah land here on earth. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
I have to begin by saying I think my mom was right back in 1991 when I decided to go to college in Ohio instead of attending Austin College that I got into and said no to. I think I'm regretting that choice now, hearing them sing. And I'm going to call her tonight and tell her she was right, and that'll make her entire week. So, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Derek Starr Redwine, the pastor for discipleship here at the church. I work with our lay leaders in the realms of mission and discipleship. We here at the church have four partners in the East End we work with to bring about, to empower the people of the East End to live a full life, a life of purpose and meaning and joy and peace. We give our hearts to them, our resources to them, and our time as well. And it's a good fitting thing to have music and mission come together, because both music and mission, to be effective, have to come from the heart. Enough of me talking. Emily Small is here, the lead organizer from RISC, and she's going to tell you a bit more about who RISC is and what they do.
Good evening. Wasn't that an amazing concert so far? So as Derek said, I'm Emily Small, the lead organizer of RISC, which stands for Richmonders Involved to Strengthen Our Communities. I think many of you know, but RISC is an organization focused on justice. We build ministries of justice within our 20-member congregations, and each year they bring together a large number of organized people to hold our systems accountable to what we know God wants for his people, which is justice. God does not want people to lay awake at night wondering how they will pay the rent. God does not want people to live in mobile homes in our city with no heat and no air conditioning, mold everywhere, and water damage that is so severe that roofs and walls are collapsing. And God does not want mothers to lose sons and children to lose fathers to the epidemic of gun violence that is taking place across our city. Just this past Tuesday night, we had our annual Nehemiah Action Assembly. We had 1,200 people gathered there, many of you, I think. We laid these problems before our four city council members who were in attendance, and they made some great commitments to address these problems, basically by funding the Affordable Housing Trust Fund and by funding a mobile home repair and replacement program. Now, there's a lot more details to that story, and it took place really over months leading up to the Nehemiah Action. But you can find out more of those details. You can find out more about RISC and ways that you can get either involved at all or involved more by talking with any of our RISC staff who are seated right there and towards the front. Raise your hands, guys. Or also checking out our website, which is on the insert in your program, riskrichmond.org. Thank you very much.
So these concerts are meant to both inspire you with good music, but also give you a chance to make a difference in the world through your time and energy and resources. So all proceeds from tonight's concert will go to support the Ministry of RISC and the good work they do in partnership with their churches around the city. There's three ways you can give. Well, actually four. You can, after service here, after the concert, there's some baskets. You can place checks or cash there. There's QR codes and those nice little inserts you'll find in the pew rack in front of you. You can scan that QR code, make a donation there. And, or you can go online, fpcrichmond.org/give, and make a donation there. Or you can talk to one of the staff members or me tonight and ask how you can get involved, how you can participate in the good work RISC is doing in the world. We need you to make this work, to bring justice for all the people of Richmond. So thank you for being here tonight, and thank you for all the ways you give.
The group in front of you is called Descant. It's actually the newest group at Austin College, but by new, I mean it's new for me, which it's about 15 years old. They ambushed me at the beginning or middle of last year and said, we'd like this group. And I said, okay. And they kind of run it themselves. I get to stand here and kind of sing along a little bit every once in a while, but this is really kind of their group. We're going to sing three tunes for you. The first is a Beach Boys song, God Only Knows. Next tune is actually a standard, well, standard for me, from 1970. The original recording didn't do too well in the charts, but the Carpenters, that should be familiar, yeah, the Carpenters, uh-huh, we're all nodding and they're looking at us like we're, the Carpenters recorded this and it went to number three. It's called For All We Know.
For all we know.
And finally, I think you'll recognize this one.
That's it. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Lily Besson, and I have had the pleasure of assisting in the direction of the AC a cappella choir this year. I've had the great privilege and honor of sharing this beautiful work by Jake Runstead entitled Please Stay. It is an anthem for hope, an attempt to destigmatize mental illness and challenge all of us to support those who are battling depression and thoughts of suicide. The text of this piece is inspired by tweets using the hashtag #IKeptLiving. You are not alone. We can make a difference. We can be the support system that saves a life.
No, don't stop. worth living. I decided to ask for help instead of going through it alone.
It was hard as hell, but I kept living.
It's a little hard to follow after that. I'd like to sing a piece for you now that's actually from Australia. It's an Australian composer named Stephen Leake. And Stephen Leake writes a lot of, he writes avant-garde music. He writes music with different kinds of sound in it. But he also writes music that is very much tied not just to earth, but to spirits and the feeling of the Australian outback. And this is a piece, it's from a larger work of his. It's one of the movements called Ngayoyo.
Thank you.
We'd like to sing one more spiritual for you. We'd like to sing Ezekiel Saw the Wheel. This is an arrangement of William Dawson. If you wanted to look toward a composer who brought spirituals, African-American spirituals, to choirs like ours, it would be William Dawson would be one of one or two people. So we'd like to sing Ezekiel Saw the Wheel. Before we go, we'd like to sing one more piece for you. This is a piece that this choir has been singing after every concert since probably about the mid-40s when this choir was first formed. Traditionally, we ask alumni to come up and sing with us, and you'd think that being however far we are away from home we are, there wouldn't be any, but I do happen to know that there are two alumni in the audience. Yeah. Oh, more than two. Look at that. Thank you.